Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel guys. If you have a Ford vehicle that cranks but does not start guys, we'll explain what are the top reasons for that now guys. So you can go ahead and diagnose your car and see if that is causing your car not to start. Now, quick introduction guys, we have more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop because our mission is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video guys. Hopefully you'll find the information helpful and lead you in the right direction to fix your problem. Let's start on it now. So we'll demonstrate now guys, okay, what is causing that. Let me show you how it doesn't start. It cranks. It may start after a while, it may not, it really depends. Okay, listen now. So, a few things guys that can cause that now. First guys, things that can cause that now guys. Bad fuel pump, you're either not getting fuel or you're not getting spark. Now, what can cause not getting fuel? Okay, on modern vehicles with direct fuel injection, you even have two pumps. Okay, two pumps guys, and we will show you why. And if one of those pumps is not working, your car will not start. Second guys, okay, you have fuel pressure sensors on the fuel line. If that sensor is not working, your car will not start. Third guys, if the fuel injectors are not working, car will not start. And now, a fuel injectors guys, most of the times they have a separate fuse. You have fuses for the pumps as well, for the fuel pump, fuel injectors, and you may have a relay as well. Those are the things you need to check. For spark plug, if you're not getting spark guys, okay, you need to check ignition coils, or and you need to check if your relay and fuse is good for the ignition coils. In our case guys, okay, we'll demonstrate what is causing that now. If I turn the ignition on and off for a couple seconds, you hear the pump buzzing. Okay, usually your low pressure fuel pump will be under the rear seat guys, okay, down there. Okay, listen now. So you hear that okay, that guys is fuel pump. So if we actually have somebody turn the ignition on, okay, on and off for a short time, for 1 to 2 seconds, on, off, okay, without starting the car, no starting the car, just turn the ignition on and off, you're going to hear that pump guys, okay, right underneath, right in front of the front tire. So listen now. Okay, that pump is working guys, so we're good there. Fuel pump is working there now. You have another pump, okay, let me explain. Not on every Ford, but on most newer Fords you have a second pump that is called the high pressure pump. And if you don't have direct fuel injection, you will not have that pump. In our case guys, we have direct fuel injection, so we have that pump and we want to cover that as well. So this right here is your high pressure fuel pump guys. It's mounted on the camshaft. Turns that pump guys, creates enormous amount of pressure. That pressure goes from the fuel pipe here to the fuel rail and the fuel injectors that spray directly in the cylinders for direct fuel injection. If you do not have direct fuel injection, you will not have that pump, so you don't need to worry about that. That pump sometimes goes bad. You have a sensor that detects how much volume of fuel is going and all that stuff, and if that sensor is bad, it can cause that now guys. There is another fuel pressure sensor, okay, all the way back there on the fuel line. And we have another one guys on the fuel rail that can cause you not to get fuel as well. In our case guys, okay, this right here, okay, I'm trying to focus. Okay, this right here guys, okay, it's fuel pressure sensor on the fuel rail. This is what's bad guys on ours. So we had to replace that fuel pressure sensor. We have the video on the channel how to replace those, pretty much unscrew, put a new one in, and you'll be ready to go. Now, if that doesn't fix the problem, check ignition coils. Okay, if you're not getting spark, and check fuses for fuel pump, fuel injectors, fuse guys for ignition coils, and relays for fuel pump, injectors, and ignition coils if you have one as well. And after that, okay, let me go ahead and see if it's going to start. Car started with no problem guys, as you can see. So hopefully guys the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching. Please guys subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.